Now, back to Genesis 1 through 5. We only got 5 verses covered, and we don't know much about the agent called or named God, Elohim. We know that he created, he creates, he makes something. And as far as we can tell, it's ex nihilo, as the church fathers would say. It's out of nothing. He's not just rearranging pre-existing matter or a pre-existing world. He is creating it. And before he creates it, it's described as being nothing, without form and void, the earth specifically. And we do have a problem with the word darkness, because it was on the face of the abyss. We have basically, as I said, a two-part reality here. We have a surface of profundity, and next to that surface is God. His first action is not even really him. It is his spirit that moves on this abyss. I mean, it's hard for us to conceive of how nothing can be. Oblivion. That's the absence of all existence. So God's spirit moves on this incomprehensible oblivion, and when he moves, Tahom is called Mayim. There was a relation between his movement and the Tahom becoming Mayim. So, when his spirit moves, the abyss becomes the waters. And then he speaks. And he says, let there be light. And then it says, God saw the light, that it was good. And we spoke about that judgment call there. And God divided the light from the darkness. And God, we don't really know exactly what that involves. God called the light day. He gave names. So, what I'd like to observe here is that as this reality of heaven and earth, at this point it's just abyss, mayim, and light, as this is coming into focus, God's behavior is identified in a progressive way also. His spirit moved, and then he said, then he saw, and then he named the light day. It's as if the progress, with the progress of creation comes insight into the entity of God. That's interesting.